Yvonne, you've got a story to tell me, I think, about your childhood experience. What is the connection with you and this bridge and the works?
My father worked here all his working life until he retired. And I remember years ago him bringing me down on his bike to pick up his wages, and all the men lined up waiting to get paid. There was no going into the bank and picking your money up from there. Everybody had to come down and pick their wages up. So if it was your day off, then you came down. And I can remember coming over the bridge with my father on the bike and being petrified because the trains were going over it, and I found it really scary. But when you look back, how many people worked here? It was wonderful days, really. Everybody had a job. Everybody was proud to work here because they were doing something that was worthwhile, that was decently paid.
Do you tell these stories to your own family, especially to the youngsters? Do you think they're aware of the heritage that's only a few years ago?
Yes, I do, because when my children are home, they live away at the moment, they come for a walk with me. And when you're walking along this path, it reminds you of things that went on in days that gone by. And I explain what the buildings are and what happened here. And really and truly, they can't believe it now because it's such a different world from what it was then.
Did you ever accompany your father on his bike?
Yes, I did.
And where were you sat?
I was sat on the crossbar, on a little seat on the crossbar. People didn't have cars in those days. All the men either walked or came on bikes.
And how old would you have been then?
I would have been about 8 or 9.
And was it all a magical experience for you?
It was quite scary because the amount of people. I'd never been in such a place with so many men, because you just can't believe the amount of men that were coming to pick up their wages.
So you actually went into the wages office?
No, it was like the wages. It was like stalls, and everybody went to the window, and they were all queued up at the windows waiting to get paid.
How old would you be when the news was made official that this works was going to close? How old would you have been?
I would have been in my early 20s. I found it quite devastating because it was thousands and thousands of men that lost their jobs. And it wasn't just here, it was court halls as well. Court halls had started closing down as well, so it was just an absolutely devastating time.
What was the immediate impact then on your family and the people in the streets around you, do you think?
It was worrying, because where were the jobs going to come from? I mean, to say we were one of the lucky ones, really, because my dad kept his job here and he ended up working in the new coatings works. So we were lucky. We were one of the lucky ones.
Did you take encouragement from what the local politicians and the councillors were trying to do to establish new industries to replace the steelworks? Did you feel that that might be a lifeline to Deeside?
I didn't at the time, but you can see it now. You can see the fruition of it. It was the Deeside Enterprise Zone, wasn't it? And you can see the fruition of that now. But at the time, you couldn't, because there wasn't the jobs there for all those people at the time that lost their jobs. This wasn't just a few hundred, this was thousands of jobs that were lost.
Is there something special about Deeside and its people that give them the courage and resilience to carry on?
Yes, I do. I do think so, yeah, because we've come through the end of that storm, really. I know it was a long time ago, but people have come through it, and it's become a better place in a way, hasn't it? We've got cleaner industries that aren't as dangerous. It was a dangerous industry, and at least the industries that have been they've brought in now aren't as dangerous as they were.
Roy and I are here today to try and recreate, capture something of the essence of the works, and in particular the cycle run that many of the shift workers had to do twice a day. And we're hoping to eventually, if we get enough recollections like this, to place it in the National Archives. Are you happy that we use anything that you might have said this morning?
Yes, yes, more That's than happy.
Kind. Well, thank you very much for your
thank
help
you.
This morning.
Thank you.
And I hope that you go on to enjoy Shotton, Queen's Ferry and all the good things that are in North Wales and Deeside especially.
Yes.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.